Hello students, welcome once more to online video class for class 8 computer studies. Today we are going to study some more terms related with the internet. So you know, in our today's session we will discuss what is URL, what is domain name, IP address, domain name server, internet service provider, bandwidth and internet connecting devices. So without wasting the time, let us start our topic. Starting with the URL, in the last video also I had explained this term, what is URL. So once more we will see what is URL. URL is a location on a net server. Every web page on a website has a unique address, which is known as the URL or Uniform Resource Locator. As you know, website is a collection of many pages. So each page of a particular website has different URL or different address. The URL of any website contains three parts. First part is the type, means this website belongs to which type. Second part is the domain name or the address of the server where this website is kept. And third part is actually the path of the file that is opened on your system. The path of the file contains domain name along with the file name which is opened on your system. Suppose we have an example of Airtel website. The URL of Airtel website is airtel.in. If you type only airtel.in in the address bar of the browser, then the first page or the main page of the Airtel website will open on your system. Your system may be your laptop or desktop or tablet or mobile phone, whatever may be. But the complete address of the URL of Airtel website is starting with http://www.airtel.in/index.asp. When we enter only airtel.in, then also the same page will open because server will add some prefix and some suffix in the address that you type using the address bar of the browser software. So in the complete address of Airtel website that is highlighted on the computer screen. So first part http://. Actually here HTTP is known as Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It means this type, this website belongs to which type or which type of server. The protocols we will discuss in the next videos. Now the second part, that is www.airtel.in. This is the name of the server, or we can say the domain name of the website. Now after the slash, third part, that is index.asp. This is the file which is opened on your system. As you know, every web page has a different URL or different address. Like a website is a collection of many pages, so each page will have different address. So this is the address of the index page of Airtel website. Now if you combine all the three parts together, that is www.airtel.in/index.asp, then it is known as the complete URL, or we can say the complete path of the file index.asp, which is opened on your system, but this file is present on the server of airtel.in, and this server belongs to HTTP, that is Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So I think it should be clear to you now what is URL, Uniform Resource Locator, or website address. Now we will proceed to the next topic, that is domain name. Just now we have discussed airtel.in is the name of the domain or the name of the server. So what does it mean? Domain name is equivalent to the address of a website on the internet. Like every one of us has a address where we live or where we have our residence. So using your address, anybody can approach your residence or your home. But in the same way, on the World Wide Web or in the internet, there are billions of pages or web pages. So how we can directly go to a particular page? For that we need the address or exact address of that page. For that we need domain name of the or the server name where that page is kept. So domain name or server name is the address of a website on the World Wide Web or internet. For example, airtel.in is the domain name or the server name. Now on this server, actually the server is the computer on the internet, which is connected with the internet, where websites are kept. So on the server of airtel.in, many web pages are kept. So to access a particular web page, we need the particular file that we want to access. So on that page, main page of Airtel, you will get many links that will take you to different pages. So you don't have to learn the address of each page, because hyperlinks are provided on the web page. So we just have to take our mouse pointer over that link. That link may be in the form of text, that we say hypertext or hyperlink. So it can be in the form of text of blue color. It can be in the form of picture, button. So clicking on that, when we keep our pointer over that hyperlink, the arrow symbol will change to hand symbol. It means it is a hyperlink. So by clicking on that link, it will take us to that particular page for getting more information. So I think domain name should be clear to you. Domain name is nothing but the address of the website on the internet where the website is kept, and website is a collection of many pages. Now the domain name is consists of three parts. The main name of the domain name is airtel.in, but when we enter airtel.in, then the system automatically adds some prefix and some suffix. So prefix is www and the suffix can be .in, .edu, .com. It depends on the extension of that website or that domain name. So now we will study what is IP address. IP full form is Internet Protocol, and address, you are familiar with that. IP address can be thought of as a unique series of numbers uniquely identifying a computer on a network. Every computer which is the part of the internet is distinguished by its IP address or Internet Protocol address. IP address of any device on the internet is unique. Like everybody has a unique mobile number in the world. In the same way, every computer which is connected with the internet or which is the part of World Wide Web has a unique IP address. With that IP address, a particular computer is identified on the internet. Not only a particular computer, a particular device which is connected on the internet is identified. That device may be a laptop, desktop, mobile phone, tablet. IP address is a series of numbers. There are four numbers, four set of numbers. They are separated with dot. Example we are going to discuss now. Every IP address can be either 32-bit long, which is the old format, or 128-bit long, which is the new format. In case of old format of 32-bit, like I have told you, every IP address has series of numbers. So there are four parts in that IP address. Example is 192.168.1.1. So dot separates the four parts, but every part should be equal to or less than 255. That is the condition. Each part cannot be more than 255. So I think IP address or Internet Protocol address should be clear to you. Now domain name server. It is very difficult to keep in mind the IP address of all the websites we visit. Words are easier to remember than string of numbers. This is where domain names come into picture. When you visit a website, you need to know only the URL of that website. So we can remember or understand the URL that is in the form of letters. But computers don't understand letters. Computer understands IP address. So the URL is converted into IP address, and it is converted by domain name server, which is a server on the internet. Domain name server are the internet's equivalent of a phone book. They maintain a directory of domain names and translate them into IP addresses. For example, domain name of Airtel website is airtel.in. So we can easily remember the domain name. And same thing we can type in the address bar of the browser. So after some time, the main page of Airtel company will be displayed on the screen. But actually when we type airtel.in and press enter key, then a request goes from our system to the server. Actually we have typed domain name. Now the browser first needs to get the IP address of that airtel.in. Only then that page will be identified on the internet. So first our request is sent to the domain name server, which contains all the domain names along with their IP addresses. So server, domain name server will check whether that domain name is present on that server or not. If present, then domain name server will return back its equivalent IP address, that is internet protocol address, which is equivalent to series of numbers, and that will be returned to our system. Then our system will search that particular server on the world wide web. But if the particular domain name server does not find that domain name, then server will transfer the request to another domain name server, where the domain name of that website is present and its equivalent IP address is present. So after getting the internet protocol address of that website from another domain name server, the main server where our request was sent, it will be returned back to our system in the form of IP address, and that IP address can be found on the world wide web. So for us, domain name is very easy to remember and learn or write, but for computer, domain name is not understood. Computer understands the IP address. This is the reason domain name servers are required, so that user's request, which is sent in the form of domain name, can be converted to its equivalent IP address, and that computer can be identified on world wide web. Now the next topic is internet service provider. With the name itself, it is clear that the company or organization which provides internet services to the users is known as internet service provider. For example, all the telecom companies provide internet facility to their clients along with the voice call. For example, Airtel, Vodafone, Reliance Jio, BSNL, they all provide internet facility. They are all telecom companies. But apart from the telecom companies, there are some more internet service providers in the form of broadband service providers. Cable operators also provide internet services, so they can also be considered as ISP or internet service providers. Some other companies are also providing high speed broadband internet. Now, bandwidth. The term bandwidth is generally referred to the volume of information per unit of time. For example, in 1 second, how much data can be transferred? The measurement of the data per second can be considered as band width. An internet connection with a larger bandwidth can move a set amount of data much faster than an internet connection with a lower bandwidth. For example, if the bandwidth is 60 Mbps, that is 60 megabits per second, and another bandwidth is 30 Mbps, that is 30 megabits per second. This is the speed of broadband, not the speed that we are using in our mobile phones. So 60 Mbps means 60 megabit information or data can be transferred in 1 second. 30 Mbps means 30 megabits data can be transferred in 1 second. And using our mobile phones, when we transfer file, then we see the speed in the form of kbps, that is kilobits per second. Sometimes when the speed of the internet is very fast, then we can be able to see 1 mbps, 2 mbps or hardly 3 mbps. So 1 mbps means 1 megabit information can be transferred in 1 second. So more bandwidth means more data can be transferred in a unit time. Less bandwidth means less data can be transferred. Now the next topic is network connecting devices. The devices which are used to connect our devices with the internet or with the network are known as network connecting devices. Computers need networking hardware in order to connect to each other. Routers, hubs, switches, bridges, gateways are all pieces of networking equipment that can perform slightly different tasks. A router can often incorporate hubs, switches, and wireless access within the same hardware. So these are the topics for today's session. I will suggest you to revise all the topics and see my video by repeating it again and again so that you can understand all the things clearly. In the next video, we will cover some more terms related with the internet. Till then, take care. Thank you.